Welcome back. We'll continue with the treatment of chronic maxillary sinusitis with the Cadwallop procedure. Cadwallop procedure is the fenestration of anterior wall of maxillary sinus and the surgical drainage of sinus into the nose via nasal antrostomy. This procedure was described by George Cadwall in 1893 and 4 years later is described by Henry Lucan in 1897. The indications for this procedure is treatment of chronic sinusitis, removal of polyp, removal of cyst of foreign bodies, reduction of facial fractures, closure of oroantral fistula. The procedure can either be done under local anesthesia or under general anesthesia. An incision is placed on the mucobuccal fold at the level above the apices of canine, the incision extending from the canine till the second molar region. The dissection is extended through the mucosa, submucosa, the facial musculature and periosteum, taking care not to injure the infraorbital nerve. A bony window is created using a burr or a ronger, and the window is enlarged with a burr. Care is taken not to injure the roots of teeth while exploring the sinus floor. After the removal of tooth, implant, tumor or cyst, antrostomy is performed to improve drainage of normal secretions and reduce the chance of recurrent disease. If there is pus is drained, or if there is any pathology, it is removed with copious saline wash. And if there is any bleeding, sinus is packed with ribbon gauze and adrenaline for 1 to 2 minutes. Once the bleeding is arrested, it is irrigated with saline packed with iodoform gauze with one end of the gauze through the natural antrostomy or through small incision placed in the buccal vestibule. After complete debridement and lavage, wound is closed with watertight closure. The complications associated with Cadwallop procedures are pain, facial paresthesia, epistaxis, oroantral fistula, nasal obstruction, and recurrent sinusitis. Thank you.